Watching Kamala Harris make history last week beside Joe Biden led Milwaukee grandmother Denise Calloway to take her own big first step, volunteering for a campaign for the first time ever.
That pig really put something on your heart.
Oh my gosh, in a way I didn't really expect. I mean, if I'm being honest, when I saw her walk out with him, I teared up. I cried. It is a moment in history that I don't know that I expected to see.
It's African-American voters like Calloway who've helped Democrats win Wisconsin year after presidential year, from 1988 until Donald Trump won the state by less than one percentage point in 2016. Black turnout in Milwaukee County that year shrank 19%. Small business owner Terrence Collins voted for Barack Obama twice, then stayed home in 2016.
To me, it was like picking evil against evil. It was kind of like, so it was like, I'm going to kind of sit this one out because I really didn't like neither one. Mm-hmm. But now, looking back, I wish I would have voted for Hillary.
27-year-old Tempest Booker has never cast a ballot for president.
Are you more engaged this time? Are you paying? Are you?
Absolutely. I am. I feel like my vote counts because the police brutality with our black men, something needs to be done because I have boys.
The fight for equality and against police violence came up again and again in our conversations with voters here.
Everybody's woke now. Everybody gets to see what we've endured or we've been going through for so many years. And being part of the solution is getting out and voicing your opinion and getting your vote out there.
Terrell Martin has been a Democratic activist since the 1980s.
How does Joe Biden take that energy and use it to help get elected?
We have all those issues in the city of Milwaukee. Unemployment. So he has to address those issues that the young people are looking for in order to be elected.
Calloway told me that the Harris pick is evidence Biden is listening and will address those issues, and she intends to help him get the chance.
It's very important that as African-American women, we mobilize, because there's one thing that African-American women have learned about when someone is the first, and that is that we all need to rally around that person who's the first so we can make sure there's a second and a third.
Our votes. I believe it's T.I. in a very enriching commercial who says our vote is our mic. I love that metaphor because a mic amplifies your voice so that you can be heard. T.I. is saying that our vote is our mic. And with that being the case, the sad reality is even though our vote is our mic, we have a Republican Party in this country that is determined to mute our mic. This past Monday, I was on a Zoom call with Reverend Jesse Jackson that was being led by his wonderful granddaughter. It was Reverend Jackson's turn to speak. And all of a sudden, as Reverend Jackson was ready to speak, he discovered that his mic was muted. How frustrating was that? Reverend Jackson had something powerful and prophetic to share, a contribution to make, but he could not make the contribution because his mic was muted. Is that not a powerful metaphor for what's going on as Republicans in the name of power over patriotism are determined, here it is, to mute our mic as they suppress the vote with surgical precision. They are muting our mic. Watch them on the one hand lift up eulogistically the name of John Lewis, but then hypocritically they don't stand for the John Lewis Voting Rights Act because they are determined to mute our mic. They want to mute our mic by playing games with voter registration, playing games as they draw funny lines called gerrymandering. They are playing games, and as a consequence, they are determined to mute our mic. They want to mute our mic, and as they mute our mic, they get in bed politically with outsiders of this country, such as Russia, that are determined to hack this election. And when you look at the illicit implicit relationship between voter suppression and the muting of our mic, and they're opening the doors for Russia to hack this election. We are witnessing, because of Republicans, the dismantling of our democracy. They are determined to mute our mic. Understand, as they mute the mic, that they are missing out on the contribution when they tried to mute our mic. Reverend Jackson had something to say, a contribution to make. We were missing out as being the beneficiaries of his prophetic brilliance because his mic was muted. How much is this nation missing out because you were determined, Republican Party, to mute the mic? But don't think that's the end of the story, because Reverend Jackson, with undiscourageable determination, pressured or pushed on through. And you know what happened? He was able to unmute his mic. He refused to quit until his mic was unmuted. There's the metaphor for us Democrats, and that is, we have to have that Jesse Jackson prophetic determination and make up our minds that we are going to push on through until our mics are unmuted. What does that look like? Push on through until we pass boldly the John Lewis Voting Rights Act. Push on through until we have automatic voter registration. Push on through until voting day, until election day is a paid holiday. Why? Because Reverend Jackson wants us to think big. I heard Reverend Jackson say, I'm anxious that we see ourselves bigger than we see ourselves. Why? Because in many instances, we have a grasshopper mentality when God wants us to see ourselves as giants capable of pursuing and claiming the promised land. What am I saying? I'm suggesting with Reverend Jackson, now is the time to be courageous, confident, and compassionate. Now is the time to be bold in our policies. Democrats, this ain't no time to be mealy-mouthed. This ain't no time to lose your spine. Use your spine for your backbone. Stand up straight and boldly move forward with policies that will transform this country. This is the age of George Floyd and Breonna Taylor. In their name, we need bold policies that will transform our policing system so that we reimagine public safety. We have to have bold policies that insist that health care is not just a privilege for the few at the top, but it is a right for all of God's children. We need to have bold policies that determine that we are going to put an end to environmental racism, which is right there on the front lines of climate change, which has our planet in ICU. We need some Democrats with a backbone who will have the courage and the compassion to recognize the wisdom of Jesus, because Jesus said a nation will be judged by how it treats the least of these. And right now, I remix Jesus, because Jesus would look at this country and Jesus would say, I was hungry and you cut aid to dependent children and you would not give me a living wage. I was thirsty and you contaminated water in Flint, Michigan and other impoverished communities around this nation. I was sick, but I did not have access to affordable health care, and COVID-19 took me out. I was in prison because of mass incarceration and a criminal justice system that was criminal and downright unjust. I was a stranger, and you had the nerve to build a wall, while at the same time you have in the harbor there in New York a Statue of Liberty saying, give me your tired, your huddled masses yearning to breathe free. Jesus will say, America, if you don't get your act together, you may well go to hell. Why? Because in as much as you do it to the least of these, my sisters and brothers, you are also doing it unto me. We need to unmute the mic and remember Jesus. I love it, because Jesus, during the march on Jerusalem, y'all may call it the Palm Sunday processional, And Jesus is making his way into Jerusalem, and the crowds are crying out, Hosanna. And when they cry out, Hosanna, I love it. There are those conservatives who say, Jesus, tell them to chill out. Tell them to be quiet. But y'all know what happened. Jesus said, no, I don't want them to be muted. I want to unmute their mics, because if these hold their peace, the rocks are going to cry out. Jesus unmuted their mics and they cried out, Hosanna, save us, liberate us from Roman occupation and oppression. Save us, liberate us from economic exploitation and political repression. Jesus unmuted their mics. And when your mic is unmuted, you know what can happen. I guess I'll give it to you like this. I'm done. When you unmute our mics and we go ahead and vote, look what can happen with our votes. Justice can roll down like waters and righteousness like an ever-flowing stream. When our mics are unmuted, watch us vote in politicians who are not just about power, but about representation and the quality of their service. Watch us when our mics are unmuted and we vote, because with our votes, we will elect politicians who do justice, love mercy, and walk humbly with our God. Watch us with our votes rock the mic. That's what I've been trying to say. We about to rock that mic, and when we rock that mic, that means we will have the next president of the United States, Joseph Biden, the next vice president of the United States, the amazing Kamala Harris. But we've got to rock the mic, and when we rock the mic, I promise you, America will truly become one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. We are here to rock the mic, because our vote is our hope that is going to be used as our rope to get out of the hole. Here it is, the hole of the unraveling of democracy that we are experiencing under COVID-45, who has been disastrous in his presiding over COVID-19. But the good news is, because we are rocking the mic, we have a, here it is, we have an end to this pandemic. A vaccine for COVID-45 is to rock the mic. And when we rock the mic, America will become America for all of us. When we rock the mic, America will become a true nation of greatness, whose greatness is not behind her, but in front of her, because we are determined to rock the mic. And guess what? I'm so determined to rock the mic for Joseph Biden, for Kamala Harris, that I will fight to rock the mic. And when I fight to rock the mic, I know we're going to win. Jesse Jackson put it like this: we never lost a battle where we did not fight, but we've never won a battle when we did not fight. And so we've got to fight to win the battle. And since Jesse did not quite get you, I got to go with my boy Kendrick Lamar. Kendrick Lamar throws down by saying, all's my life I had to fight, but if God's got us, we then gonna be all right. We gonna be all right in the United States of America, because mine eyes have seen the glory of the coming of the Lord. We gonna be all right because we shall overcome. We gonna be all right because Dr. King put it like this: the arc of the moral universe is long, but it bends toward justice. We gonna be all right because truth forever on the scaffold, wrong forever on the throne. Yet that scaffold sways the future. Behind the dim unknown stands God within the shadows, keeping watch above his own. We gonna be all right because God is on our side. And since God is on our side, all's my life I had to fight, but if God's got us, we then gonna be all right, because our vote is our mic, and I'm determined to rock my mic. Peace.